And we can talk about custom interactive stages. We just covered automatic stages. So if we set up a custom verification stage, we could assign different document types to certain users. And in that way, multiple people are processing maybe large batches at the same time. And another use case could be when the same document must be verified by different operators and certain fields are assigned to certain users. And here that's being referred to as different data sets. So maybe you split a given document definition in two, and maybe the first part is personal information, the second part isn't, and you could assign the personal information fields to one group, and another group gets the other data. So those groups are custom roles. And let's talk about stage tools. A good way to learn about what custom stage tools can do for you is to go through the hands-on task in this lesson. There's really a lot that you can do, and custom stage tools are created for a project. They're at the project level. As well, custom stages can be used for batches of different types. And here we select a certain stage in the batch type workflow dialog. One thing you can do is hide certain interface elements with a stage tool. So for instance, you can limit access for a verification operator to modify the document by hiding features, and then you can have these limitations invoke for certain users and for certain stages. Another thing you can do is select exit routes to specify the next stage. Also, and this is certainly a powerful feature, you can add custom buttons. So we talked about automatic sorting. You could actually add a custom button linked to some script to do manual sorting. So like now I've made some changes and I want to manually sort the documents in my batch. But you could do many other things, not only just scripted items, but you could do menu items, maybe some image pre-processing. You want to kind of simplify by adding a new custom button to, at a certain stage, offer the ability for a user to run some image cleanup. And the user type stage. This is a powerful automatic stage that allows one to work with external applications and take, execute, and create tasks and send them to stages. It's managed by the web service API, which is well documented in the ABBYY help file. So we talked about default out-of-the-box workflows and the ability to customize workflow. We talked about the ability to turn on an unattended schema, which drops the verification stage altogether. And we talked about custom roles, which are really oftentimes linked to custom stages, which can be automatic or interactive. Setting up custom stages and custom roles can be plugged in at the batch type level, which gives you a lot of power. So a quick summary here is on the right. We can modify standard sets of document processing stages, create custom stages for special document processing, use special conditions for routing documents to certain processing stages, and we can modify the interface of verification stages. Powerful stuff.